Does that look interesting to you guys? This could be amusing. I'm not normally in a default R440 R series. We're in it this potentially today, tomorrow. Let me just straighten this up a minute. Today and tomorrow. Unfortunately, I had to get rid of the DAF. Unfortunately, the DAF is no more. It broke down. Well, I said it didn't break down. It wasn't very powerful and it wasn't doing what we needed it for. It was fine to start with, but it's just too underpowered. It was too underpowered for us, so we had to get rid of it. We're in this for the rest of this week. Anyway, we are off to a farm in Aberyth.
As you can take the second exit.
Probably tell by looking at where we are in Hollyhead. I've got an 18 ton load on the back of my substrate. Plant substrate. I think so, you pronounce it, I'm not sure. Anyway, some sort of chemical thing, I don't know. I'll put on screen what the load is. So you're heading to Aberyth. It was quite an easy run over here from Manchester. Not really, huge amount to report, and you are squishing my sack. I'm having a night out tonight. That's another factor already. I knew I'd be on a night out. So yeah, doing this today and tomorrow potentially. Tomorrow is weather dependent. I've got to go to a yard that we go to regularly. And they've just asked me to upload some slabs. Unfortunately, I'm not allowed to film it because it is literally get there, do it, and go. So Yeah, hopefully. It's a quick routine job and not a 5-year project that we'll just have to see what the weather's like. So today we are out in Taylor Louise. Taylor Louise is our 2015 Scania R Series. It's a top line cab with 440 brake horsepower. She's a mid lift. I was considering fitting a tag rest, to be fair. I was really tempted. So she's an R440 mid lift, top line, 12 speed Optitude cruise transmission. I think that's about it. Anyway, guys. Definitely are not HGV friendly.
Navigation resumed.
I almost went the wrong way. There we go. Yeah, we're on the hectic side. To say the least. There's a couple of quite tight turns just getting round through that small little village we just drove from a module, what it's called. Which to do it's not, I don't think it's suited for HGVs of my size and length. I certainly wouldn't mind taking out an all line through there, that's for sure. I've tried and avoid taking that over to that way. I don't mind taking an empty line over that way. But when you've got a 25 to 35 ton excavator in the back, it's just a no-brainer. You have to go the long way around. Come on. Speed. Whereas we're moving, we're fine. It's just getting there. Anyway, I'll talk to you in a bit. I hate this spend. I can't see where my trailer is. There we go. Be around. I really detest the European trails. So, I will take it if I have to. But I don't usually enjoy it. But we'll see. That was sci-fi. That is probably one of the worst beds to have a house on. Anyway, I'll see you when we get to Amberath, just in a bit. This run actually, as you would have seen. Oh, this is any fun. This looks very dodgy. I'm not going to lie. I can't see where my trailer is. But it's a little bit dodgy. To be fair, I've had traffic behind me for quite some time, so since I'm able to pull in, just gonna pull in here a sec. Let the traffic die. I'm so quickly in the climb. I'll go back to you in just a moment. Okay, I'm back. Just went to climb. Roads are getting a little bit busier. Not that much busier yet. We're still going to find a traffic light spot on just to make the roads seem a little bit busier. Because the default traffic is fairly light most of the time. Now, as soon as we get tipped, we need to head to Jusons to collect another leg. I don't know if we're collecting from Jusons or whether we're collecting from this farm. Does that look interesting to you guys? This could be amusing. I can't make that turn, I don't think. Probably gonna turn around somewhere. Yeah. I don't think I'm getting up there. No. Yeah, that looks very dodgy.
Navigation resumed.
That's definitely going to turn around somewhere. There is a little turnaround point up there somewhere. Yeah, but there's no way I was going to get from the side I was on. I'll just take out the wall. one of those prisons that we were at the time either. So, yeah. Really caught me off guard. So, as I felt delivery, cinema, just I need to go right into Aberyst, turn round and double back on myself. Actually, hang on, how much? Oh, I've got 12 hours.
In 200 meters, turn left.
Yeah, I should have enough time to make my delivery. I see that going far too quickly. And waiting whether to, I won't have enough time to dig to and come back. And there is nowhere safe to park up where we are.
Roundabout, take the third exit.
So that is my mission right now, is to find somewhere to park up. Oh my. I won't lie, when I said this roundabout is as tight as a cake. I don't even know where I need to. I was in the right lane. I should have run straight on. Okay.
Navigation resumed.
I was ignoring this up another minute because what I really want to do is trying to just park up. But obviously with me not being in Aberyst for crumbs for nearly a year. Trying to remember your way around somewhere. It's a bit of a challenge. No, because I know that a rest point, that is a good, that is a really good sign, actually.
At the roundabout, take the third exit.
Why is no, I'm not going to take a bird exit. Do that Swiss exit when we're coming off. No way am I going to make that bend.
Navigation resumed. At the roundabout, take the third exit. Navigation resumed.
In terms of stress of the job, you need to try and have backups in place. So then if you've got backup in one place, you need to try and think of a couple of other spots you could potentially park up at. Thank you.
Transportation resumed.
Lizard Promenade. So I can get a quick escape in the morning. Find them out here. See you guys in the morning. Right, we've got 2 hours. Let's see if we can get this delivery. If we can get out of there. The real test is remembering the way we came in. So the access passage is very tight. I spoke to another driver last night and he says it is not safe. It looks very dodgy from the entrance and it gets dodgier. So this will be fun and games.
In 200 meters, turn right.
I was just doing a reset for all I wanted to be on there. I also then, once I called Klein, I had a phone call from the office. It sounds like we're going to be going to Exeter on Friday now, and it sounds like all the work for Thursday might get cancelled. So it might be about to go to Hawes. Obviously, weather's rendered at the moment. But we'll just have to wait and see. If you're going to Hawes, I need the fridge trailer. Because I ain't taking a curtain, so an insulated or a curtain side of there. And probably I need to take the rear of the axle one, to be perfectly honest. So if all my work gets cancelled for Thursday,
at the roundabout, take the first exit.
This is going to really muck me up, but I could potentially take
at the roundabout, take the second exit.
Take Thursday off and work the weekend as well. Which, as much as it sounds crazy, I could do a Friday to Thursday week, which would be Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I'll work it somehow, but it sounds like I might be working Sunday and I might be having to push the tackle through its limits and do a 7 day week, which means working on a Sunday, Saturday week, which
I
don't mind doing.
Take the second exit.
I've done them before. They're not ideal to do, but if you have to do it, you have to do it. Especially if you're on vital goods. Because it sounds like I might be on vital goods.
Turn right.
Again. But I don't know whether those regulations have been tightened back up again or what. I've never been to Garden before. Tell you what, one of the nicest things about doing what I'm doing is, and I've said this before, but no 2 days are ever the same. I was on about a month, maybe a little bit less, day tripping. I was pretty much doing the same thing day in, day out. And I was getting fed up with it. Yeah, I know I brought the other one with me. And but me just doing London to Dover, Southampton to Dover and Southampton to London and to Cardiff, it was getting really, really boring. And to the point of where I just thought, you know what, I need to take some time off. So I then took some time off from work, and then I'm like, you know what, I miss tramping, I want to go back to tramping. And here is the dodgy term. So I went back to tramping. Alright, let the fun begin. They said it was dodgy. Oh my. Oh wow. Yeah, this is definitely dodgy. Ah. Yeah, this is, I don't like the second bend. Oh, that's fucking. Alright, let's give it another shot. It might be that I might need to win it. Having to make it. Only just. Need some really intense music at this point, because this is, like, no joke. Hang on a sec. I'll put the photo studio mod, hang on, photo studio. I'll insert a couple of features for you guys, just to show you how tight it really is. I was really hoping it wasn't there. Here. Because if you guys tip it in here, that would be no thank you. Yeah. You see why I said it looks a bit dodgy? Aren't you? Now, it might look wide, but it really isn't. At all. Which is why I am voicing myself here. Because with the 60 foot long, I've got an unfamiliar trailer on the back, and I'm still trying to get used to the tail swing on it. This thing looks really dodgy. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie here, this looks really quite dodgy. Anyway, we certainly ain't made for a class one truck. That's for sure. The trailer, please. That's all for left. There we go. Fifth race. Now I know it would be dodgy. I didn't think it would be that dodgy. That was ridiculous. Oh my gosh. Right. This next man looks quite innocent currently, but I could be wrong. I could be wrong. Nah, it's not too bad. To be fair, the worst one of the other ones. I think coming out it'll be worse. Over here. Okay. Possibly. Maybe.
You have arrived.
Hello guys, I'm in the video here. Well, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, give me a big thumbs up. Any comments, queries, or concerns, let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep safe. See you on the next one. Bye.